Hi everyone, this is Kalyan Kumar and welcome to Product Review. This is another edition of Cool Features of PowerPoint, and this is titled Focusing on a Part of an Image. Now it can so happen that you want to present an image in a PowerPoint presentation, but you do not want to reveal the entire picture in the beginning itself. You might want to focus on only a part of an image, and you might want to focus on different parts at different times. Now, say for example, you have a group picture. Let's say there are six people sitting or standing, and you want to talk about each person as that person's image comes up. But since it's a group photograph, if you reveal all of them, then you'll have to use a pointer or some mechanism or a mouse perhaps to tell the public about whom you're talking about. So therefore, what happens is that becomes a little bit difficult. And it is also possible that you're talking about person X and the audience is looking at person Y or Z. So to make sure that everybody focuses on the same picture, the same person, in a group picture, rather than trying to break them apart or do anything like that, we can do a very simple trick in PowerPoint. So let me go ahead and show it to you. All right, so I'm opening PowerPoint 2016 here. Now you need not have this, you may have even 2003, it'll work, but it must have morph transition in it, which is only possible in 2013 and 16. I'm changing the layout to a blank presentation. I'm going to minimize the thumbnail view, not collapse it completely. Now I'm going to take a group picture. Yeah, this one is good. So I'm going to put in this one, click and drag. You can even do insert, and I'm going to resize this as it is, a high resolution image. It doesn't really matter for this particular presentation. It doesn't matter whether I change the aspect ratio or not, but you should try and avoid doing that. So this is the picture that I'm using now, and the way to go about this. Now, if I show it to you just like that, this is what will appear. And every time I want to talk about this lady, I'll have to point my mouse over her face. I don't want to do that. So how do I make sure that only her face is revealed? This is what we do. We go to the insert tab, or perhaps even the home tab. You have these shapes here, and you have to go to this hollow. It's called circle hollow. So zoom out as much as you can and just create a circle hollow. We can resize it later on. Now this is the circle part and this is the hollow part, okay? So I'm going to make sure that her face is inside this. But as you can see, the hollow part is pretty big, doesn't matter. We have this yellow looking thing and it will resize it to her face and make sure that it is the center of this. Now, the fact of the matter is these guys are still visible. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to zoom out and I'm going to increase the size of this to cover the slide. And then resize it back to her face. So now everybody else is going to be covered with this. Only her face is revealed. Everybody else is covered. But as you can notice, there is this blue line around the circle. That's because the line is still there in it. So go to Format, Shape Outline, Remove Shape Outline. Now you will not see that. So now you see only her face now. So then what do we do? Then how do we go to the next one? Duplicate this. Go to the second slide. And now just move this and focus on the next guy. It is as simple as that. But make sure that this part still covers the entire slide. If not, resize it again. Then go to duplicate this. Then move on to this woman. Yeah, you got to make sure that even if somebody is not the same height, you got to make sure that everybody gets their chance to be inside the hollow circle. So then it is this lady. Yeah. Duplicate this. Move to this person. And you can adjust, of course, the circle as appropriately as you want. Nobody below. Yeah. So next is this guy. And duplicate this. Next is this person. I think the hollow needs to be a little bigger in this. So perhaps I'll increase it a little bit. Yeah, and do we have any more? I doubt it, but let me check. No, there's nobody else. So I delete this slide. Now what I'm going to do is from 2 onwards up to 7, I'm going to select all the slides and apply morph transition. And this is what happens. And let's make this color black. So let's format this to color black. Fill. Black looks better if you want to highlight something. And so let me get the format painter. Hit this. And if you know what format painter does, go and check out my first video on cool features of PowerPoint and you'll be able to understand. But I'm not going to do this format in the seventh one, because in the seventh one I resized this, so I'm going to apply it black separately. Alright, now let's check out how is this presentation happening. So this lady is there, the circle moves, and can you see it is focusing on each person moving and the last person. And the best part is you can move back. You can press the left arrow key and it will go back. But the first one will be, the first slide will be a little different than the rest, because I did not apply morph transition. Okay, so there it goes. Beautiful, isn't it? Another thing that you can do in this is that rather than making everyone else opaque, covered under a black sheet, what you can do, you can make this black tower, the hollow circle, to be transparent, which means the others would be revealed, but they will be pretty dim because of the black screen on top. And this is what you can do. So I click this and I take the transparency, let's say 30%. So see, they're visible, but not. So again, I make sure I hit the format painter, make sure that everything else is also transparent. And here I'm not going to hit this. I'm going to make the transparency 30% manually because I changed the circle size. And now let's look how it appears. Now can you see everybody is visible, but we are focusing on one person. And then we are focusing on this guy. So we talk about this guy. Okay, this guy is like this. Then this guy is this. The moment you apply this kind of a focus effect, it comes out, it jumps out of the presentation and people are watching the person you're talking about. So I'm just taking an example of a group picture, but you could be doing with any other picture also or any other part of your presentation. For example, you've created some kind of a drawing or something on your presentation and you want to focus on one part, you can use something like this to make help you with. So with that, this video comes to an end. I hope you liked the video as much as I loved making it. And if you have any comments, suggestions, anything that you want to talk about, any suggestions or any requests, please drop them in the comment section below. This is Kalyan Kumar signing off. Have a great day. Goodbye and thank you for watching. If you find the videos of this channel interesting and useful and you haven't subscribed to this channel, then go ahead and hit the subscribe button just below the video. The moment you're subscribed, you'll find a bell icon. Click this and it will give you a notification which says send me all notifications for this channel. This means the moment any video is posted in this channel, you'll receive a notification by mail. Just check this box. Hit save. Now you're subscribed to this channel and now you will also receive notifications from this channel. If you like this particular video, make sure that you hit the thumbs up button.